came from Powertrain Products. I think they're based in Maryland. That's where I thought the motor was coming from, but I was mistaken all this time. It was actually shipped from Texas. And that's where the core is going back to. Pretty good company. That came with a lot more than I thought. I mean, of course, not like it was free. I paid for it, but it's got a, I think I paid for the 5 or 7 year no-fault warranty. No matter what happens to it, they'll give me another one, even if it's my fault. So, I'm going to get it all together. A couple little odd instructions they give you. I guess not odd, but I can imagine anybody would spend all this money on a motor and do all this work and not put a new PCV valve in it. The intake manifold has to either be cleaned free of cracks or put a new one on. I have a new Motorcraft one. Just heads up on a couple things that they require you to do for the warranty. And I think I've just about got all those bases covered. So the intake's not over there. It's in the, actually in the back of the truck. But you can't put that on until the motor's in there. Another thing, if you don't have that Ford lift bracket, and I'll show this when I get it on the crane to put it in. I already marked the bolts because, of course, the engine stand bolts are going in the same holes that you're going to put your whatever lift mechanism you're going to bolt into in the back. I wouldn't recommend bolting into the head. So you got enough room where you can put a bolt halfway in both directions. That's how I did it. It held just fine. Bolts didn't bend. It wasn't up in the air that long anyway. And then, of course, I used these in the front. And I used that OTC engine tilter, which this thing works incredible. But I'll get to all that when I'm dropping it in, hopefully later. Not sure what I'm going to do first. I think I'm going to put this quad together and get it out of the way. It'll just make it easier moving things around. But stay with me. I'm hoping it'll all go fairly easy. And if it doesn't, well, maybe it'll be something to laugh about. All right. Get everything cleaned up and ready to go here. Looked up all the torque specs. So the first thing we have to put on, this is the oil filter adapter, they're calling it. And it's got one stud, which thank God my core didn't go back yet because I left a stud in the motor. The old motor, and that goes in one of these, and now I don't remember which one. Matters. All right, get everything cleaned up. Let's start putting this back together here. I'm going to put the oil cooler adapter on, which is this thing right here. The gasket goes there. It takes one stud in the back here. Lucky my core didn't go back yet because I left it in there and this one didn't come with one. Sees on it. I really think it was in the top. I don't remember, even though I just took it out. I looked up all the torque specs. And the reason I don't think it matters is because I think it's really only there to aid with hanging this thing on there. So I can't imagine it would matter other than interfering, but I'm going to take a look at, before I go any further here, I'm going to take a look at the manual and see if it shows, or maybe I even have a picture of where the stud went. And I'll be right back. All right, service manual says it goes in the bottom. So I'm glad I looked. I honestly don't think it would make a difference. But rather than get it all bolted on and then try to get the exhaust manifold on just to find out the studs in the way. Not worth it. It is muggy and hot. I can't record with the fan on, so my big fan is off. Alright. We got that. 1, 2, 3, 4 of those. Some bolts here. There's two different size bolts that go into this. I didn't actually should have individually bagged them, but I didn't. Thank you. gasket looks like. And the motor came with a Ford gasket, which of course I already purchased. Didn't know it was going to come with it. I don't think there's a... I don't think there's a top or a bottom. I should say, I don't think it matters which side is, which side's coming out. Go in, there's a O-ring in the gasket, so I got, maybe I grabbed the wrong bolt and I reached over there to the table. Alright, that's all torqued. Showed the same torque spec for these smaller bolts as these larger ones in the service manual, so I just went by what it said. I mean, I don't think these are quite a bit larger than those, but again, I did what the manual said. Next, I'm going to put these exhaust studs in. They're not copper, they're actually stainless steel coated with copper. And they've got this E-Torx end, which I never heard of until a couple days ago. I think it's got that. If we can get that in there. I worked on a generator the other day. Had the same studs on the carburetor. So you need one of these bits for it. You got them off of the... where everybody buys things online. These two gaskets. This is the Ford one. which normally I'd like using factory parts. And this is the Molly one, if that's how you pronounce it. I like this one better. I'm going to go with this one. Hopefully I don't regret it. That one looks like it's triple steel with a coating, and this one is, the Ford ones are double. I don't know if you can see that. And a new dipstick tube too. These are factory Ford exhaust manifolds. There's a lot of aftermarket ones, but the Ford ones are a little more, but they're not ridiculously expensive. And I just want to see if this should have pulled that out to start with. All right. Put that on your O-rings. One more thing, quick thing before we move on. This truck doesn't have an EGR system. It's exempt. So you need this plug for that exhaust manifold, and Ford does sell it. It's some kind of, I had a pipe thread in there at first and it didn't fit right. I don't even remember what size it was. So when I emailed the dealer where I get my stuff from, they said they have them. They put it in a bag and they send it to me. And that fits perfect. Alright, so the next thing I'm going to do is get the motor mounts and the motor mount for this side anyway, and this studs for the Y pipe. I think we'll stick the water pump in, the balancer on, and move over to the other side. All right, well, I made a mistake. These three bolts hold the motor mount on. That's why it only showed that one torque spec. So the torque spec was for these cooler bolts, and then I'll look, I'm sure that's under the motor mount section or spot there on that page. So I take them back out, and because it did show a specific torque for this stud and this nut, so I take these back out and I'm sure there'll be a torque for that. I'll be right back. All right, my service manual doesn't have any torque spec listed for these motor mount bolts for some reason. It has it for the six point eight or whatever it is that 10-cylinder one. What I was able to find on the internet, 45 foot-pounds for this. I don't know, chose the torque spec for the diesel in the 6.8 to 5.4, it doesn't show it. Get a good bite on this one. Alright, next I guess I'll get ready to put the valve cover on, the oil dipstick tube, and continue on. I have to go look at the pictures and see which bolt holds that dipstick tube on, because I don't remember. Well, that took entirely more effort than it should have. Getting the dipstick tube in. I don't know if you can see. I'll point it out. You'll be able to see behind it, so I'll do my best here. And I'm putting a 7/16 wrench there and one of my pry bars here and hitting the wrench. I'll go grab the old tube and show you what I'm talking about. Putting the wrench up against it like that. Didn't go in easy. I'm hoping I didn't lose the O-ring. It just seemed like a lot more effort than it should have been to get it in there. I mean, I even pulled it out at one point and matched it up against this one, and it was perfect. I think the problem was the way it was curved. It was going at the wrong angle. All right, got the valve cover on. One quick thing, the gasket that came with this motor, it wouldn't fit in the groove. I don't have another one other than the old ones. These little bumps here that are meant to hold it in. Like my Mercury has them, but there's actually a spot in the valve cover where they fit into. So I had to go through and shave them all off. But in the end, it's on there. Then I had to go back to my pictures and figure out which one of these. Oh, can't turn it. Figure out where the bolts went and where the ones with studs go. no point in really pointing this out because they're not all going to be the same. I can't turn it. So the next thing is to torque them down. And see, it's got the seal on it, and then you just got to force this bottom part will force through the actual valve cover gasket. When you're tightening, you'll feel it pop in. There's not really a wrong way to do it. So let me look up the torque and the sequence, and we'll continue on. I'll be right back. Torque on these is 89 inch pounds. There's a sequence. But even if you didn't have it, you can pretty much just work your way out from the middle. All right, this valve cover is done. Exhaust manifold. It's no different than the other side. And then I gotta put the motor mount on. And this will only go on one way. I don't know if there's any arrows on here or anything that'll show that, but mounts on these four bolts here. You can see one, two, three, four holes. Just the only way it'll go on is with the half moon part up. So I'm gonna put Loctite on these. I'm not 100% sure it had them on there from the factory, but the bolts are all the same. Four in the bracket on the motor and four that hold the mount the bracket. And I'm just going to go with the 45 foot-pounds again. You torque these first. I'm pretty sure you can't get to them once the mount's on. I'm done with this. Put the balancer on. Have to look at the picture and see how this goes on here. Because it's not the same up and down. The holes are pretty much. This is looking like it's only going to go on one way, too. Stuff you don't think of when you're taking it apart. Alright, so it only lines up that way. And there's no marks on this or anything. Every now and then the Ford engineers get it right. Oh, I know I had all eight of them. Days we put the balancer bolt in and just run it in with that. It's frowned upon these days. Someone made a tool. You don't ever want to tighten that up in there first. I'm just got to get enough threads in there. It doesn't have to be tight on this end inside the crank. I made that mistake on my daughter's Jeep, and I have a hell of a time getting this out because I'll actually put this in the vise to take it out. This came apart. Two things left to do for today. Water pump. It's a Motorcraft one.
I'm going to put that balancer bolt in tight and torque it. I'm not going to put any of the sensors on. Crank position sensor, cam position sensor, only one on this motor. Knock sensor I'm definitely not going to put in because I'm sure it'll be the chain will be laying in there, everything, and I'm putting it in. Cylinder head temperature sensor. I think there's another one in the back. You have to look, not 100% sure on that. And can only go in one way. Play. No, you don't have to apply any sealer to these. Thinking about this, the more I think I'm gonna have to. Might have to wait until this is in the truck to torque it, because I don't know what I'm gonna do to stop this motor from turning. Because the initial torque. Okay, 66 foot-pounds, and then back it off 360 degrees. I'm going to guess at 66, this motor's going to want to turn. No flywheel on your flex plate, so there's no way to stop it or jam it. I
But we'll see.
Not long enough.
Look at the next thing.
The back list off. So you just loosen it. Drop to reverse that strap. And tighten it to 39 foot-pounds. Tighten 35 to 39 foot-pounds. Turn it an additional 85 to 95 degrees. Basically a quarter turn. Hold it with the strap wrench so it doesn't move at all. Shouldn't be too difficult. There. That's just about 90. Good enough.
I'm going to make a YouTube debut.
Right?
64. I took the bolt out.
it is. It's going in. That's Butch over there. We didn't get rained on. We're sweating that bad. It's 100 degrees.
Didn't get rained on yet.
Ready? Maybe I should put the legs out. Yeah, it's tipping.
You need me on the back end with it?
I could hold it down.
You're going downhill if you're going
to jump. That's alright, just tell me what I gotta do.
Okay. Now.
I can see the bolt though up there. We're close.
Jeff, give that tranny like a half a pump. Go ahead. Good, right there. Okay. Now almost everything's lined up. Yep.
Ratchet or air? Can
yeah.
You get to it?
Yep.
What size is it? Jack, grab me one of those bolts. So I just.
Looks like 12 maybe?
One of those 15? Bolts right behind the rear tire. You need an extension, Butch, or can you get to it with the ratchet?
Just the ratchet.
Hold on.
Gotta get this back bolt in.
Hold on.
Take a little tension off of it.
Hang on.
And pull that motor forward a little bit.
Billy, let me just get me. Oh, it's almost there.
It's right there. All right, pull it again. There.
You got
in.
It, Dale.
Then.
Watch your fingers, Butch.
Go ahead. There it sits.
Woo!
Yeah, boy.
And the torque converter is nice and loose.
Good.
We did something right.
So it's not pinched or...
Nope. That's a torque converter.
Let's take showers and get drunk, boys.